It is National Hispanic Heritage Month, and NBC2 is sharing the stories of Hispanic people who have made extraordinary contributions to our community. New at 5, NBC2's Evan Dean spoke to one man whose family is credited with founding Fort Myers.
Where the water winds through Manuel's Branch flows a story as old as the creek itself. It's by water that Fort Myers first began, by the very man whose name remains here. Captain Manuel A. Gonzalez was born in 1832 in northern Spain. At just 14, he voyaged to Cuba, later to Key West, and eventually, during the Third Seminole War and the Civil War, he was sailing north. Woody Hansen knows his story well.
That's my great-great-grandfather.
Has good reason to.
He was a sea captain. And he sailed a mail boat between Fort Myers and Tampa, connecting Fort Brooke with Fort Myers, delivering mail to and from. So in a way, he was the cultural merchant who connected this area not only to Key West and to Havana to the south, but also to Tampa to the north.
By 1866, the war had ended, the fort in Fort Myers abandoned. And in February, Captain Gonzalez came back, this time with family and a close friend.
When Captain Gonzalez got here, 1866, he sailed up and occupied an abandoned structure at the fort, you know, so he became the lonesome family on the new frontier.
He became the founding father of Fort Myers. And he had a son of his own, Manuel S. Gonzalez, who, as years passed, became a gifted builder. This among the homes he built as the city grew at century's turn. Still today, it remains. It's one of two homes that now make up the Veranda Restaurant in the heart of the city.
Here we are today, and like doing an interview at his family house.
Crazy.
Yeah. And
it's still here.
Still here. Yeah, we're still here.
Inside, the home has been preserved to help tell the city's history. The Gonzalez story shared with guests curious to learn it.
It's all about sense of place, you know, sense of time and relationship to those, you know, the narrative, the myth, the folklore, the legends that define us.
And in a city defined by one Spaniard's quest, Hansen believes celebrating its history is to celebrate its Hispanic heritage, its diversity.
The history of this city is a Hispanic story. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Ground zero. Now, that's the story of Fort Myers. It's like this came out of a group of people that had diverse backgrounds, but yet they have found a way, you know, to unite and work together as they needed to do to overcome the challenges of the frontier.
As the water runs still today in the creek bearing Manuel's name, remember the sea captain, brave enough not only to explore a new place, but to find a way with those different than him. Still today, a life we can learn from.
I think so. We get a lot more accomplished together than we can, you know, like pulling on different ends of the rope.
Reporting in Fort Myers, I'm Evan Dean for NBC2.